have to do this my way. You tell me what you know, and I'll confirm. I'll keep you in the right direction if I can, but that's all.
People have been fascinated for 33, 34 years by the question of deep throat since we first published All the President's Men. Well, it's logical. First of all, he obviously, as we described him in the book, was somebody in a sensitive position in the executive branch.
He insisted on the ground rules of absolute confidentiality.
There was this elaborate system of meeting involving flower pots and flags. It's not your ordinary source.
And he swore me to the kind of secrecy I don't think anyone has ever sworn me to since.
It introduced a kind of mysterious element to the story that I don't think we thought quite so much of when we put it in the book. And the name Deep Throat, we were so used to using it because it was just a term that was given because the information was coming on deep background. I don't think we gave it too much thought as to how fascinating it would be.
I want to talk about Watergate. I know that
we're not going to talk about that subject.
I remember I got a phone call from a man I didn't know, John Dean, who was Nixon's lawyer at this point. And he had just somehow gotten a hold of the screenplay and said, "Who said that line?" And I said, "I wrote it." And he said, "Damn, I would have known who Deep Throat was if somebody had said that to you." I mean, everybody was trying to figure out who was Deep Throat.
It occurred to me early on that a source high up either in the CIA or the FBI was likely Deep Throat.
On May 31st, 2005, at the age of 91, Mark Felt, former deputy director of the FBI, revealed that he was the anonymous source who helped Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein crack the Watergate case. Mark Felt was Deep Throat.
History will remember Mark Felt as the quintessential secret source, secret man. They will remember him, I believe, as somebody who displayed extraordinary courage. They also will probably remember him as the ultimate tormented man.